Hi guys, and welcome back to a new vlog. So today it's going to be a little bit different. It's going to be sort of a weekend in my life kind of video because I basically vlogged over Friday and I didn't really start the vlog properly, chat much in the vlog, didn't explain what was going on. So I felt like I needed to put an explanation to it, and I thought I'd just chat to you afterwards about what I did over the rest of the weekend, because this weekend has been a super busy one. But yes, you may have seen, if you've been watching previous vlogs, me and Luke have been together a year now, and he had a surprise planned for me for Friday and I didn't know what it was, and he told me on Thursday night, and he had basically booked train tickets to and from London so we could have a full day in London and use our Merlin passes, which, if you don't know, Merlin passes are basically like annual passes that get you into so many different places around the UK. There's Alton Towers, Thorpe Park, the London Dungeon, Sea Life, London Eye, Blackpool Tower, Legoland, so many, there's loads. So he planned for us to go down to London and spend a day using our Merlin passes. I thought I'd just talk you through the day and then show you the clips afterwards, because yeah, I just wanted to explain what we did throughout the day and sort of show you. So we got the train to London at about 10 to 8 in the morning, and that got us there for about 9:30. And the first thing we did was go and have a Mackey's breakfast. Actually, we quickly popped into HMV so Luke could get or try and find the pop vinyl that he wanted. But then we went for a Mackey's breakfast, then went back into HMV for a bit just to look around. And then we went to the Disney store, which is the massive Disney store on Oxford Street. If you're not aware of it, it's amazing, but you're about to see some clips from that now anyway.
Yeah. Look at Minnie. She's like shook. Cruella de Vil. If she doesn't scare you, no evil thing will. Hector. There's a flame. Oh my god, I've not seen the flame one before. I'm gonna wait. Look at the stage. There's a Chip and Dale mug.
You're very close, Ian.
This is going to be all the time.
Why is Goofy up there?
I'm actually gonna wee myself. What an absolute bop. Oh, look at the mirror. Think of snow, think of sleigh bells, off you go like reindeer in the sky. You can fly, you can fly, you can fly!
After exploring the Disney store for a bit, which was amazing. Then we ventured over to Madame Tussauds, which was the first thing we used our Merlin pass for the day, and I've only been there once. I've been to the one in Blackpool once as well, but I've only been to the London one once, and that was 7 years ago. So it was nice to go back and see some of the new wax figures and also see some of my old favourites. I absolutely love Madame Tussauds. I think it's such a cool concept, and so many of them look so realistic. To me, the most realistic looking one of the day was definitely Eddie Redmayne. It was scarily accurate. It was really weird being up that close because it just looked exactly like him. Obviously, I've never met Eddie Redmayne in person, but I've seen him on TV and in photos and stuff, and oh my god, it was so good. Like, it was an amazing waxwork figure of him. But now you will see some clips from when I went to Madame Tussauds.
Where are we now, Luke?
SeaLab Centre.
Not sure we are, hon. We've just walked into this room, randomly found loads of celebrities. How weird.
They're not very... standing really still.
Yeah, they're not very talkative.
A bit weird.
So weird. Oh, what a
babe. It's so creepy.
Oh my god, it actually looks real. Isn't it weird? There's just Kylie chilling over there as well. Benedict's Cabbage Patch. Some very cool waxworks, and two especially that I have been waiting to see for the longest time. I saw Zoe and Alfie's waxworks, which was incredible. Obviously, I've met them in real life, but seeing their waxworks was so cool, and they were definitely realistic. They were made quite a few years ago, so they don't look exactly the same as they do now. Obviously, Zoe's hair at Madame Tussauds is like dark brown still, and now it's changed and stuff, but they are so realistic, and it was really cool to see them. But yeah, we saw loads of different ones, and we also did this new thing that I've not seen before, and it was like this alien thing. I don't know what it was. It was like some weird walkthrough thing, and it was about these people that had been infected, and there was an alien, and we were walking through it. That was very loud. And so I was walking through it, and they had a couple of actors in there, and then it literally like pretty much just started, and then the one actor was like all infected, or like he was trying to help people get out or something, and then he was like, quick, go, 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 and we were like running through to the next bit. It was the end. We ran out, and then all of a sudden we were out back into like the normal Madame Tussauds bit, and it was so weird because it was like it just started, and then all of a sudden it just ended so abruptly. So that was one downside to it, because I thought that was a bit pointless, if I'm honest. But
Nevertheless, I do recommend Madame Tussauds. It's an amazing place. Then we went for a little walk and went and got some food, and we ended up going to TGI Fridays, which I've not been to before, and it was so nice. I really, really loved the vibe of the place. It was very like American style. It's kind of like a diner, but not like exactly like a diner really. I don't know, it's quite unique. I've not been there before, and the food was really good, and the people working there were really nice, and I just really enjoyed it. Ventured over to somewhere that seems extremely random and was also another thing that we could use our Merlin passes for, but it was Shrek's Adventure, which you're probably thinking, Esme, what the hell is that? And you're probably thinking it's for kids, which it probably is, but we wanted to give it a go anyway because we thought it'd be fun. Oh my god, I think that was my favourite part of the day. I don't know, actually, I loved everything, but that was so good, honestly. If you're thinking about doing it, I'd say go for it, it's so cool. I mean, I am such a child anyway, but it was amazing, and it was like a little taster for like Universal Studios or something, just because it was like kind of like a walkthrough thing, and it was mainly Shrek, but at the end they also had some different bits from like Madagascar and Kung Fu Panda and stuff. And I don't know, it was very Universal Studios style, but I know it's not Universal Studios, but I don't know how to explain it, and I don't think that really made sense, but it was really cool, and we met Shrek at the end, which was a dream. I loved that. My heart was like, I was literally like, oh my god, it's Shrek. I'm such a child, honestly. So I saw his wax work at Madame Tussauds, and then I met him in real life, so how amazing is that? But here are some of the clips from that experience. I didn't get to film inside because you weren't allowed to. I'll show you some of the clips I got like before and after, and sort of in like the Madagascar and Kung Fu Panda-y section. So here you go.
Luke, where are we?
The Shrek Adventure.
I'm very excited.
It's difficult, isn't it? I hope you leave this with no music.
Then we went went to the London Dungeons, which again was something that we could use our Merlin Pass for. This I didn't film anything of, the only thing I filmed was the entrance. So yeah, again, I couldn't film inside because you weren't allowed, and there wasn't anything else really in there that I could vlog that wasn't part of the actual experience, if that makes sense. So I didn't vlog anything there, but again, really, really cool. Little bit gross at times, it's a bit gruesome, but I thought I was going to be terrified, but it wasn't actually that bad. Again, it was like a walkthrough thing, different actors. It's really cool. Definitely, again, recommend it, along with all the other things we did, because everything we did was so good. And just, yeah, it was amazing. Like, so, so good. And I can't believe I've not done these things before, other than Madame Tussauds. The last few things we did was go for, like, a walk around near where the London Eye is. And basically, the places that we went to, apart from Madame Tussauds, were right next to the London Eye. So Shrek's Adventure and the London Dungeons, they were right by the London Eye. So we were walking along that bridge again. We came across that bridge to start off with, and then we went back that way and went for a nice little stroll. And it was really, really lovely. And then we popped into the M&M store and also the Lego store. And these are like the last few clips of the day that I actually got. So I will just show you those now.
Book of poems and your slippers on in the sitting room, in the sitting room. And I'll hear you whisper in the dark, sitting up in the night with your head in your arms in the empty hall, in the empty hall. And in the dawn, the sparrows sing from the cherry tree that you have put in. I'll watch the light lie across the lawn, like all those times that you did before. I'll never know which books you read, darkest fear as you lay in bed, but I'll share your room, yeah, I'll share your room. In the kitchen where you cut your arm, left your blood on the floor where the kids were born. So the life goes on, yeah, the life goes on.
There were other bits and bobs that happened in between, obviously, and I obviously didn't vlog everything, but that was pretty much our day. And then we got the train home about 9:15, and got home about 10:30, and it was such a lovely day. I can't thank Luke enough for it. It's just really sweet of him to book train tickets to London as a surprise for our 1 year. Like, that's such a nice thing to do, and I had the best time, and I really do appreciate it, and I'm very thankful for him and everything, and I just, I'm very happy, and it was a really lovely day, and I just can't get over the fact that he did that for me, so I really appreciate that. I loved every second of it, and I just didn't want it to end. It was just such a good day. And like, some of the stuff I got to do, like Shrek's Adventure and London Dungeons, not done it before. It was incredible. So, so cool. After that, we came back to mine and I quickly packed some stuff and I went over and stayed at his. And then on Saturday, we had to get up early again because we did a filming day with our theatre company. I think I've spoken about this in vlogs before. Basically, we've been doing some TV and film acting, and we had a filming day at a location, and the short film that we did that they're gonna like edit together is gonna be shown in the next showcase that they're gonna show on the screen, which is really cool. So yeah, that is how I spent all of Saturday. We were outside all day at a farm, so it was very cold. It was cool to do some TV filming because I've not really done any of that before, so it was interesting to see that side of, you know, acting and how it's different to theatre. And then after that, I came home, defrosted, went to sleep at about 9:45. I was very tired. And then today, which is Sunday, I got up not as early, but I think I got up about 9 and started getting ready to be Rapunzel, because if you don't know, I've done character parties and stuff before, and my cousin does them, and she had asked me if I could be Rapunzel at a party for a couple of hours, and then we were going straight to another one where I was face painting and she was being Harley Quinn, and also my cousin Gilbert was Spider-Man and the Joker, so that's really cool. So I did all my makeup and everything, then headed over to Laura's house, got the wig and costume on. I'll insert a quick picture here because it was like a really cool costume, because it was like more like the one you'd get at the parks. It's really cool, and the wig, and yeah, it looked amazing. So Laura's friend very, very, very kindly drove us around for today, which I really appreciate. And she obviously took us to the Verse venue, and we got there and there was no one there. And we were asking people who were working there or owned it, and they only had a party booked in for like later on in the day, and it wasn't the same people. So basically they had just not let us know what was going on, and they'd booked a party, given Laura a date and a time and a venue and everything, but then they just didn't show up, or they weren't there and didn't tell Laura that it wasn't happening anymore, or if there were any changes. So that party didn't end up happening, but at least I got to put the outfit on anyway, because I loved seeing myself in it and it just made me happy. And even though I didn't get to do the party, it was really cool to at least have the outfit on for a little while. And then we headed to the other party, which didn't get cancelled randomly out of nowhere, and the people just didn't disappear into thin air. This one actually happened, and I did some face painting, which is not my forte. I've not really done much of it before, but I gave it a go and I think I did okay, and I quite enjoyed it, to be honest. The couple of hours went quite quick, I think because I just didn't stop. I was constantly face painting, but I did enjoy it. That was till 4:30. Oh, and also we went for Mackie's because the party wasn't happening. We just went into Mackie's, and I was dressed as Rapunzel and my cousin was dressed as Harley Quinn. So we just went in and had a Mackie's, and we got a few weird looks and stuff, but I just didn't care. And I got some McDonald's out of it, so it's all good. But then I came home, and now I'm home. And I've listened to George Ezra's album finally, because I didn't get to listen to it when it came out. Came out on Friday, and I've only just got to listen to it. It's so good. Oh my God. I can't believe I'm going to see him. It's such a good album. Yeah, that is the end of this crazy weekend. So this was more of a weekend in my life vlog. Not every weekend is like this, of course. This is just a weekend where it's been a little bit more crazy, but I am extremely exhausted, as you could probably tell, because I went to sleep before 10 o'clock last night, and then I woke up at about 8? Was it after that? I kind of woke up and went back to sleep a couple of times. But we also did lose an hour last night. The clocks went forward, so technically I got 1 hour left. I think I got about 9 hours sleep overall. And then obviously I've had another busy day today, so I'm spending the rest of the day just trying to chill out. That is basically what my weekend has consisted of. The battery has just started flashing. I'm glad it lasted this long anyway, to be honest, because I haven't charged it since Friday. So I vlogged all day in London. I haven't charged it since, like, before then, so the fact that it's lasted that long is quite a good thing. But that was my weekend, and I hope you enjoyed this vlog. I know it's kind of all over the place, and you probably would have preferred me to just vlog properly on Friday, but it was really difficult. It's quite busy. I'm still trying to get better at vlogging in public. I feel like I'm slowly getting there, but I was just really, really nervous. You'll see a couple of times where I got a bit more confident, but yeah, it's something that is a work in progress. And obviously I couldn't vlog yesterday or today because it was just so hectic and something that I couldn't really film. But I hope you enjoyed this vlog anyway, something a little bit different, and hope you enjoyed some of the clips that I got from London and just hearing about my weekend. But if you did enjoy this vlog, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Sorry if this vlog is a long one. I'm not sure how long it's gonna be, but I will see you in the next video. Bye. True.